Rocky.
And John, the rain's still falling here in Barnhart tonight. Take a look over here. You'll see a couple canoes resting. They were using these today to transport some of the sandbags that they made out to areas that are flooded. Now, flood baggers had two goals. The first was plan A. They were using that today. Let's sandbag, try to keep the water back. Now they're going to plan B. That's keep sandbagging, but let's start moving people's belongings to higher ground. Dark clouds packing more rain rolled through Tuesday night. It's the last thing these sandbaggers needed. The volunteers have been working on Highway M just east of Interstate 55. They ran out of sand early this evening. They need more, as well as donations of boxes, cartons, or plastic tubs.
So people can get their stuff out. We just wanted to get it out. The water's coming up. It's bad.
People have come from across the area to help.
These small communities need help. And the first picture I got this morning, there was four people out here, and two of them were kids. So as soon as we could rally some people, it's time to come down and help.
Mary Ditter's fireworks stand is flooded, but she's not worried. She's a flood veteran.
I've been here 33 years. We'll be back June 20th. Maybe a day or two late, but we'll be open.
A few homes back and the trees already have 4 inches of water inside. These houses are still dry and they're hoping to keep them that way. It's a community where people are quick to offer a helping hand.
If your house is flooded, you probably want help too. So that's what you do with neighbors.
And they tell me they will continue their efforts tomorrow. Reporting live here in Barnhart, I'm Rocky Madden. Fox 2 News.
Also